To get Don and Lena in those romantic moods. Cosmo I agree with whatever RF and thinks.
Ladies and gentlemen, you should see this glorious couple. It's no wonder that they are like a household name all over the world, like bacon and eggs. Lockwood and Lamont, Dawn, you can tell me confidentially, are those rumors true about that wedding bells are about to ring for you and Lena?
Well, Dora, Lena and I have no statements to make at this time. We're just good friends.
Just good friends? But Dawn, just good friends. Do I hear the wedding march?
Cosmo, can you play the wedding march? Oh,
Dawn, you've been through so much together. Won't you tell us how it all happened?
No, Dora, not in front of all these people.
But Dawn, the story of your success is such an inspiration to people all over the world. Please.
Well, Dora, I've had one motto that I've always lived by. Dignity, always dignity. This was instilled in me by my mom and dad from the very beginning. They sent me to the best dance school, where I met my lifelong friend, Cosmo Brown. And with him, I was able to perform for all of mom and dad's society friends. Over me. Then, if I was good, I was allowed to accompany Mom and Dad to the theater. They brought me up on Shaw and Moliere, the finest of the classics. Training at the conservatory. In a few years, Cosmo and I were ready to embark on a dance concert tour. We played the finest symphonic halls in the country.
For love.
You are a criminal. I've seen that place someplace. You're a famous gangster.
Lockwood.
Don Lockwood?
How are you, Mr. Lockwood? Out for a stroll?
Actually, yes.
Anything I can do for you?
No. No, thanks.
And you, young lady?
Why, no.
You sure are a lucky lady. Good night, Mr. Lockwood.
Good night. Well, thanks for saving my life. I'd very much like to know whose hospitality I'm enjoying.
Selden. Kathy Selden.
Enchanted, Miss Selden. I'm sorry to frighten you. I was getting just a little too much love from my adoring friends.
Oh, that's what you were running away from? You can't even go out for a walk? That's terrible.
No, it's not terrible at all. We movie stars get all the glory. I guess we need to take the little heartaches that go along with it. People think we live lives of glamour and romance. The truth is, we're lonely. Terribly lonely.
Oh, Mr. Lockwood, I can't tell you how sorry I was to have taken you for a criminal before, but it was understandable under the circumstances. I knew I'd seen you.
Well, of course. Which of my pictures have you seen?
I don't remember. I saw one once.
You saw one once?
Yes, and you were a...
Julie?
Yes, and there was a girl. Oh.
Lena Lamont.
Right. Well, I don't go to the movies much. If you've seen one, you've seen them all.
Thank you.
Well, no offense. It's just that, well, I'm not interested in the movies. I guess it's entertaining enough for the masses, but the personalities on the screen don't impress me. I mean, they don't act. They just make a lot of dumb show. Well, you know. Like that.
You mean like what I do?
Well, yes.
Wait a minute. You mean I'm not an actor? Pantomime on the screen is not acting?
Well, of course not. Acting means great parts, wonderful lines, speaking those glorious words of Shakespeare and Ibsen.
And what's your lofty mission in life that lets you sneer at my humble profession?
Well, I'm an actress.
What?
On the stage.
Oh, I'd like to see you act. What are you in right now? Maybe I can brush up on my English, bring along an interpreter? That is, if you let in a movie actor.
Well, I'm not in a play right now, but I will be. I'm going to New York, and I'm gonna...
New York, and we'll all hear about you someday, won't we? Kathy Selden as Juliet, as Lady Macbeth, oh, as King Lear. You'll have to wear a beard for that one, of course.
Oh, you can laugh all you want to, but at least the stage is a dignified and honorable profession. And what have you got to be so conceited about? You're nothing but a shadow on film. You're not flesh and blood.
Oh, no.
Stop.
Oh, don't worry, I won't bother you.
Keep away. Just because you're a big movie star, wild parties, and swimming pools, you expect every girl to fall in a dead faint at your feet. Well, don't you touch me.
Well, fear not, sweet lady. I will not molest you. Nay, I am only a shadow. And you, my fair damsel, are a figment of my imagination. You stepped out of a dream. You are too wonderful to be what you see.
I'm sorry I didn't recognize you before. I should have my eyes examined.
They look wonderful to me.
Could there be eyes like yours? Could there be lips like yours? Could there be smiles like yours? Honest and truly, you stepped out of a cloud. I wanna take you away, away from the crowd, and have you alone and apart out of a dream. Safe in my heart, you stepped out of a dream. You are too wonderful.
Do you think that they'll ever really use it?
Oh, I doubt it. You know the Warner Brothers are making a whole talking picture for this gadget. The jazz singer. And they're going to lose their shirts. What do you think of it, Dexter?
It will never amount to a thing.
Ah, you know, that's what they said about the horse, the scarab.
Oh, there you are, Nutty. Where have you been? I was lonely.
Hello, Lena.
Ah, my two little stars. Alone at last. Now, aren't they wonderful, ladies and gentlemen?
Oh, yes.
Okay, on with the show. A very special cake, full of delicious surprises.
Oh, it isn't Ethel Barrymore. Well, I hope you're going to favor us with something special tonight. Hamlet's soliloquy, or maybe balcony scene from Romeo and Juliet. Oh, come on, that's a perfect costume for Juliet. We could just watch it. New part, Cop Pierre de Bazelay. better known as the Dueling Cavalier.
Oh, what's this one about?
French Revolution story.
I've got it. You are a French aristocrat, and she is a simple girl of the people, and she won't even give you a tumbrel.
Well, it's a living.
You know, why do you even bother shooting this picture? Why don't you just release the last one under a new title? You know, if you've seen one, you've seen them all.
Why did you say that?
Say what?
Well, that's what that Kathy Calden said to me that time.
3 weeks and you're still thinking about her.
I can't get her out of my mind.
Well, how could you? She's the first dame who hasn't fallen for your line since we were four.
She's on my conscience.
Well, it's not your fault that she lost her job at the Coconut Grove.
I gotta find her.
Well, you've been trying, haven't you? I ain't short of sending out bloodhounds and a posse.
I suppose so.
Oh, come on, Don, snap out of it! You can't let a little thing like this get you down. You're Don Lockwood, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, and Don Lockwood's an actor, isn't he? Well, what's the first thing an actor learns, huh? The show must go on. Come rain, come shine, come sleet, come snow, the show must go on. So remember. Short people have long faces. Long people have short faces. Big people have little humor. And little people have no humor at all. And in the words of that immortal bard, Samuel J. Snodgrass, as he was about to be led to the guillotine, make them laugh, make them laugh. Don't you know everyone wants to laugh? My dad sent me, and after my son, but be a commodore one will be standing in line for that old honky tonk monkey shine. Now you could study Shakespeare and be quite elite, and you could charm the critics and have nothing to eat. Just sit one on one man and feel the world at your feet. Make them laugh, make them laugh. Make them laugh, don't you know everyone wants to laugh? My grandpa said go out and tell him a joke, but give him plenty of hope. Make them roar, make them scream, take a fall, bust a wall, split a seam. You start out by pretending you're a dancer with grace, you'll wiggle till they're giggling and all of the boys, and then you get a great custard pie in the face. Make them laugh, make them laugh.
Ha ha ha! Hello, Mr. Dexter.
Hello. Hey, let's get those lights up, fellas. Hey, what are we waiting for?
Hey, where's Lena?
Miss Lena Lamont, to the set, please.
Miss Lena Lamont, to the set, please.
Miss Lena Lamont, to the set, please. Here comes Miss Lamont. That office is my name.
I know, I know. Here comes our lovely leading lady, Lena. Hey, let's go.
Gee, this wig weighs a ton. A dope would wear a thing like this.
Everyone used to wear them, Lena.
And everybody was a dope.
Yeah, you look great. Hey, let's get into set. Hey, where's Don?
Mr. Lockwood on the set, please.
Mr. Lockwood on the set, please.
Mr. Lockwood on the set, please.
Mr. Lockwood is on the set.
I know. Hello, Don. I'm so glad you're here.
Where were you the other night? Your phone rings. Honey, I was looking for you.
I was busy.
Hey, give us those lights, Lloyd.
Hey, I know what you were busy at. You were looking for that girl.
Actually, yes.
What?
I was worried about her. Yeah, but you didn't lose your job, and she did.
Your job, too, she did. I made sure of it.
What?
They weren't going to fire her, so I called them and told them that they fed up.
Why, you...
Now, remember, Don, you're madly in love with her. But you have to overcome her shyness and timidity. Okay, Cosmo? Mood music.
Hello, Mr. Brown.
Hello, Mr. Brown. Hello, Mr. Brown.
Rollin! Okay, Don, enter. You see her, you run to her.
Why, you rattlesnake, you got that poor kid fired.
That's not all I'm going to do if I ever get my hands on her.
I never heard of anything so low. What'd you have to do it for?
Because you loved her, I can tell.
So that's it, but believe me, I don't like her half as much as I hate you. You rattlesnake!
Sticks and stones may break my bone.
I'd like to break every bone in your body.
You and Faust can be lovers.
And kiss her, Don. That's it. More. More. Great. That's perfect. Absolutely perfect. Cup,
guys!
Meet the greatest actor in the world. I'd rather kiss a tarantula.
Oh, you don't mean that.
Oh, no? Bring me a tarantula. Listen, Lena, I'm telling you...
For the lunch chit-chat you love birds, let's get another take.
Hold it, Dexter, hold it!
But Mr. Simpson, we're re-rolling.
Well, you can stop rolling at once.
Huh?
Ah, oh, Lena, come here.
All right, everybody, save it!
Save it! Save it!
Save it!
Save it! Save it. Come on, go home. We're shutting down for a few weeks.
Shutting down?
What's the matter, all right?
The jazz singer! That's what's the matter, that jazz singer! It's a sensation! The public is screaming for more!
More what?
Talking picture! Talking picture!
Oh, that's just a freak.
Yeah, we should have such a freak at this studio! Now, I told you all that talking pictures were a menace, but you wouldn't listen to me. Now, we're gonna put our best foot forward here. We're going to make the Human Cavalier as a talking picture.
Now wait a second, RF. Talking pictures? Why don't you just take your time? You look, you try, you sing.
Every studio is jumping on the bandwagon. The theaters are putting in sound equipment. We do not want to be left out of it.
But we don't know anything about this gadget. You look, you try, you see.
What's to know? It's a picture. You do what you always did. You just add talking to it. Now, talk. That would be a sensation, believe me. Lockwood, Lamont, they talk!
Well, of course we talk! Doesn't everybody?
Lena, your talking may bring back the silent picture.
All right, now, Cosmo, we're going to watch this thing through. Shoot in 3 weeks, work night and day.
For talking pictures?
Yes.
Well, that means I'm out of a job. At last, I can start suffering and write that symphony.
You're not out of a job. I'm making you head of the new musical department.
Oh, thanks, Hopper. At last, I can stop suffering and write that symphony.
Warner Brothers, watch out. Monumental Pictures will be soon be making musical movies and motion picture history!
Thank you.
gorgeous mixture of autumn light under the big blue sky. My cry, beautiful girl, your dazzling eyes, oh beautiful girl, I could never trifle if I had you. You'd be my dreams come true. They're painting blondes and brunettes there that are hard to resist, but you surpass them like a queen. You've got the lips that were meant to be kissed, and you're over.
How could I help but realize?
very beautiful girl.
That's terrific.
Thanks anyway, Mr. Simpson. It was nice of you.
Now, hold on a minute. What's up?
That's all right, Mr. Simpson. Well, there's no point discussing it any further. I'm halfway off this lot right now.
No, what do you mean?
Well, before Mr. Lockwood refreshes your memory, you might as well know I'm the girl that hit Miss Lamont with the pie.
Oh, God.
Believe me, it was meant for Mr. Lockwood. Sorry, Sid, I should have told you. Goodbye.
Just a minute, Miss Selden. What's this all about, Art?
Oh, we were going to cast Miss Selden in a featured role, but if it'll make you and Lena unhappy,
I think it's wonderful.
Yeah, he's been looking for her for weeks.
Yeah, are you speaking for Lena too, Doc?
Well, the owner of the Coconut Grove may do what Lena tells him to do. But you're the head of the studio, right?
That's right. That's right. I am the head of the studio. She's hired. Just don't let Lena know she's on the lot. All right, it's settled. Phillips, take care of it.
Thank you, Mr. Simpson. Thank you, Sid.
You deserve it.
Oh, Kathy, we're so glad we found you. We've been looking at every cake in town.
Thanks, Cosmo.
Taxi!
Have you really been looking for me?
I turned this whole town upside down. I even got the New York office on it. I remember you said the New York stage was clamoring for you.
A slight exaggeration. Well, I was the one clamoring for the New York stage. In fact, I started out from New York, and then the talkies came, and I just...
I haven't thought much of the talkies, but if that's what brought you here, it's the greatest invention since the wheel.
Now listen, Mr. Lockwood.
Just because you're a big movie star doesn't mean a girl's going to have lunch with you. Just like that.
Will you have lunch with me? Just like that?
Sure.
Main dining room right this way.
Don't you usually tear a pheasant at lunch with Ms. Lamont?
Now, Kathy, all that stuff about Lamont and me, sheer publicity.
Oh, it certainly seemed more than that. Well, from what I read in the columns and in all those articles in the fan magazines...
You read the fan magazines?
Well, I glance at them in the beauty parlor. The dentist office? Well, I only buy 4 or 5 a month. And you do achieve a kind of intimacy in all your pictures that would lead one to believe that...
All my pictures?
I guess now that I think of it, I've seen 8 or 9 of them.
Of course, I insist. If you've seen one, you've seen them all.
Oh, I did say some awful things that night, didn't I?
Oh, I deserve them. I have to admit, though, that I've been so upset, I haven't been able to think of anything but you ever since.
I've been a little upset, too.
Kathy, seeing you... Kathy, I'm trying to say something to you, but I'm such a ham, I can't do it without the proper setting.
What do you mean?
Wait a minute. A beautiful sunset! Mist from a distant mountain. Colored lights in a garden. A lady standing on a balcony in a rose trellis bower, flooded in moonlight. We had 500,000 kilowatts of stardust. A soft summer breeze. You look lovely in the moonlight, Kathy.
Now that you have the proper setting, can you say it?
I'll try. Life was a song. You came along. I laid awake the whole night through. If I but dared to think you cared, this is what I'd say to you. You're like a plaintive man.
Choose chooses them and chews them. Those chestnuts, cheddar cheese, and chives in cheery, charming chunks.
Wonderful, wonderful. Do another one.
Moses supposes his toes are roses. But Moses supposes erroneously. Moses, he noses his toes aren't roses, as Moses supposes his toes to be.
Aha! Moses supposes his toes are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously.
But, noses he noses his toes aren't roses, as Moses supposes his toes to be.
Moses supposes his noses are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously.
A mose is a mose.
A nose is a nose.
A toes is a toes.
Moses supposes his toes are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously. But Moses, he noses his toes are roses, as Moses supposes his toes to be. First, you gotta talk into the microphone in the bush. Okay, Now let's try it again. Quiet!
Quiet!
Quiet! Quiet!
Lights! We're all on!
Oh, Pierre! Come!
Cut! Leah, we're missing every other word. You gotta talk into the microphone. All right. We'll just have to think of something else.
The mic is in one place or now in another. You'll never get sound electronically.
What are you doing?
Wiring it for sound, honey.
Okay, now look at that flower, see? The mic is in there. It should catch whatever you say. So let's hear how it sounds, okay?
Okay,
quiet!
Yeah.
Lights! Run!
Oh, Pierre! You shouldn't have come!
What's
your
that sound?
The mic is picking up the
heartbeat.
Well, that's just swell! Cut!
Cut!
Addiction is flicking the flickers and bodies, the silence that wants you to be.
Now that should do. Now Lena, the mic is on your shoulder, darling. Just talk into the mic. And don't make any sudden jerky movements, or you might disconnect the mic. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, quiet!
Yeah.
Lights! Roll them!
Oh, Pierre! You shouldn't have come! Stop looking for danger! They will
surely... What's this fire doing here?
Your head is...
This is dangerous!
Yeah.
Thanks, my sweet.
weeks all over the country. But wait, and you will get by. Lockwood, Lamont, they're such big stars.
I never want to see another Lockwood or Lamont picture again.
That was awful.
Oh.
That was the worst movie ever made.
No.
Now the milkman's on its way, it's going to say goodnight.